1998, one lady would help to blaze a trail that would be followed by thousands of young people each year.
Dunes Learning Center, this program was designed from the ground up to be as unique as the dunes themselves. It's one of the few residential facilities inside a national park. It's easy to forget just how rare that is.
I want to learn about ecosystems because I like how they're all unique and I want to learn about that.
When this part is the wetland, each deciduous forest is on this side of the trail.
We're taking the kids through this really diverse area and telling them about the different ecosystems and the habitats. Flip over some logs, look for amphibians, the salamanders will be completely black, frogs will be hopping around, and have fun.
I value connecting kids to nature because when we say nature, what we really mean is our surroundings, our outside, and the more connected we feel to the things around us, the more we will save them and protect them. And so by connecting kids to nature, we inspire kids to protect their home and our home as a collective part of humanity is the earth. So we're inspiring kids to protect the earth.
I am interested in habitat conservation because I feel like you can't just walk over to a tree and then cut down a bird's house or something.
Environmental education shouldn't be something separate necessarily. It should be something that's integrated within the curriculum. It should be used as an opportunity for kids to engage with the world that they live in.
If you put the fourth graders, the sixth graders, and the seventh graders in charge of the world, there would be some really good things happening. They're the ones who really become passionate about protecting wildlife. They're the ones who might not have complete knowledge of what goes into pollution, but they care deeply about it. And if that's going to continue, and they're going to begin taking care of this world, they need authentic experiences. And here it is, in a program that's tried and true. So I would say please, please continue providing the opportunity for our students to have this amazing, authentic experience.
This project took more than a decade and included some significant stumbling blocks. If not for the dedication and outright stubbornness of a relatively small number of trailblazers, this innovative learning facility would never have been built.
I look back on the 1990s when Lee Botts talked about starting an educational center in the dunes. And you think back what the climate was like in conversations people had in the 80s and 90s. Lee and others were talking about we need to use the dunes to educate the next generation. We're concerned about preservation, but it's not going to last if you don't educate people in the future.
I want to talk about my friend Lee Botts. Lee Botts did something that saved the dunes learning.
She was always on pushing that idea to get an environmental learning center here.
Stubbornness. Stubbornness absolutely is a core trait in the Carmen family and I think in the Botts family as well.
Because of that determination and her ability to bring people together, it happened. And you do now see this incredible resource in Northwest Indiana that people across the nation and the world can enjoy. That's her great legacy to all of us.